So one of the most popular things among our students is dragons. We actually have an entire week-long summer camp filled with dragon science. So we have lots of experiments. Today we're just going to talk about a couple of them. We know there's so many different books that are really exciting that kids love to read. We know the Wings of Fire series is really popular. We also know that the Dragons Love Tacos series or book is really something that's popular. If you haven't seen it, this shows, and we're going to show an experiment about what happens because dragons, they love tacos so much, but what happens when they eat a taco that has spicy salsa on it and what happens in their stomach? We're also going to show you how you can do at home a simulation showing how a dragon might breathe imaginary fire. We know a lot of our students are fans of the Harry Potter series and all the magical creatures in there, many of them that breathe fire. So we are going to have a demonstration that you can only do here that actually uses real fire and shows how an animal or a dragon would actually be able to breathe fire. And finally, we're going to have our challenge based on the How to Train Your Dragon. This is also something that a lot of students love. This book shows all the different animals. And did you know that the different types of dragons in here were actually created on characteristics of real animals?
In our experiment, where we're testing the different types of salsa to the dragon stomach content, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to make dragon stomach content. In no way is this representative of reality. We're not making a gastric acid. We are making a weak base solution, so we're going to use sodium bicarbonate, which is also known as baking soda, and you should be able to find this in your pantry, and we're gonna make it into a solution. First, you're going to have in a large container, 1 cup of water, and we're going to add 1 tablespoon of sodium bicarbonate. And you're gonna stir to mix, but it might not dissolve completely. And for the different types of salsa, you're going to look for an acid you have in your house. Most likely you will have vinegar, which is also 5% acetic acid or ethanoic acid. And if you don't like the smell, you could use lemon juice, lime juice, or even if you happen to have citric acid around, you can make a citric acid solution by also adding 1 tablespoon of citric acid into a cup of water and stirring. And in addition, you're gonna find other things you have in your house, such as you could try water, different type of juices, and you're going to put them into separate containers and either label them or set them so you know which one is which. After we gather the liquids for our stomach content as well as our different salsas, we're gonna put them in smaller containers. And what we have in here are they're colored. You could either just put tape and label them. In our case, we had coloring, so we colored our citric acid pink, our vinegar green, our water blue. If you have other juices, they'll probably have its own color. And in here, we, depending on how many different salsa types we have, we poured a little bit of the stomach content each of these so we could test how they're gonna react to the different salsas. And what you also need are some sort of dropper, or in our case we have a pipette, but if you don't have that, you could actually just pour it into each of those. To test our different salsas, what we're going to do is we're either gonna squirt in some of the salsa into the stomach content. And the first one is water. The second one is vinegar. And if you see with the vinegar, we saw all this bubbling. And then the third one is citric acid. And in this, with citric acid, we also saw bubbling.